Fina Namkwaya, 70 years old and a resident of Nunda Village in Rabenge Parish, Buyisa Sub-County in Kalungu District, delivered a set of twins, a boy and a girl, on November 29, 2023. For most women, the news of conception always brings joy. This was the same for Safina Namkwaya. I was happy to receive the news of conceiving twins. At first, I thought I had conceived one baby, but after doing an ultrasound scan, I was told I was carrying twins. I was very excited, but at the same time worried as to whether I would carry the pregnancy to term. I was confident that God, who has enabled me to conceive, would see me through the pregnancy journey. After confirming that I was pregnant, I embarked on attending antenatal care at Women's Hospital and International Fertility Center in Bokoto. Later, the doctors referred me to Masaka Regional Referral Hospital, where I delivered my first baby, to avoid traveling a long distance. Namkwaya's daughter, Sarah, is aged 3. She explains what compelled her to conceive again at such an advanced age. When my first daughter turned 3, I thought it was not wise to have only one child. So I decided to conceive, and luckily, I became pregnant with twins. I pray to God for the ability to raise them into productive citizens, given that He has blessed me with His children in my old age. Previously, Namkwaya had spent 47 years of endless search for a baby. She explains what had hindered her from becoming pregnant. I got married in my adolescent years and spent 23 years without conceiving. Unfortunately, my first spouse died. I remarried but still did not conceive after 28 years of trying without success. I was advised to seek medical help from Women's Hospital in Bokoto. Tests were done and results indicated I had blocked tubes. I was given treatment and later helped to conceive my first baby. After my first baby turned 3, I came back and showed interest in conceiving again. Luckily, the medics helped me to conceive again. Despite her advanced age, Namkwaya was able to conceive twins on her first attempt of IVF treatment. She was able to carry the pregnancy to term without major health complications, as she explains. I had a discussion with my husband and we agreed to have another IVF treatment. Luckily, I became pregnant immediately and I managed to carry the babies without major health challenges. After Namkwaya was confirmed to be pregnant with twins, she started attending antenatal care at Women's Hospital and International Fertility Center in Bokoto. However, to relieve her of the hassle of long-distance travels, the doctors referred her to Masaka Regional Referral Hospital, where she had delivered her first baby. Dr. Herbert Kalema, a gynecologist at Masaka Regional Referral Hospital, who attended and closely monitored Namkwaya, narrates how she navigated through antenatal care.
She attended antenatal at Masaka. I attended her 3 times at 4 months, 5 months, and 6 months. But thereafter, of course, on the last visit, she had started having high blood pressure and she had started showing signs of heart disease. The blood pressure was going up and she had problems with breathing. She could not sit, she could not sleep well, she could not walk long distances. I think when she went back home, those signs became worse and Professor Sally intervened and took her back to his facility in Kampala.
Where there is a will, there is a way. Although Namkwaya is a peasant farmer, she struggled and saved all her proceeds to raise money to foot the IVF treatment. Although Namkwaya has been blessed with children, she is at an advanced age that she too requires a lot of care and support. She calls upon Good Samaritans for material and financial support to be able to care for her children and herself. I am no longer strong enough to provide for my children. I pray to God for wisdom and also for Good Samaritans and friends to support me, care, and raise the children. I believe God, who blessed me with the babies, will make a way for me. Dr. Edward Sally, a senior consultant, gynecologist at Women Hospital and International Fertility Center in Bokoto, confirms that Safina Namkwaya was helped to conceive using IVF technology. Dr. Sally explains who qualifies to conceive through IVF.
Anybody who is over 45 and above, they will need to be assisted by IVF. That's a general principle. Anybody younger than 45, if their tubes are blocked or if they don't have a uterus or then the man has got a low sperm count, those are some of the indications for IVF. Low sperm count or no sperm, there are some men who don't have sperm at all and you have to extract them. Those need IVF. There are some women who got a bad uterus and you cannot repair it, then those one needs...
Dr. Sally further explains how IVF process is done to enable a woman conceive and the tests done to confirm the pregnancy. He says the success rate for IVF is 60%.
It's like a mango tree. You stimulate, you give fertilizer, and then the ovary grows and produces eggs. And then you go and pick them. Normally mango, you climb the mango tree and you pick. Use your hands or you can use a stick to harvest mango. Here, we use a needle. We put it in the vagina. We go to the ovary, which is a mango tree, for example, and then we pick. We can see on the with the ultrasound, you can see where you are picking the eggs. And you put them in the basket. Our basket is not chibo, it's a glass, a tubing, a small tube. Then you put your eggs there. Then the man produces a sample, either by masturbation, by having sex. If both those methods they fail, we have can stimulate the man, electrical stimulation, and you can give a sample.
According to Dr. Sally, gender selection is done with IVF treatment based on the request by the parents.
We so balanced the family here. We had met one a man first, then he wanted to balance. So we can do that also in our clinic here. We can do gender selection very successfully.
Dr. Sally further says there is no age limit for IVF treatment. He, however, says support from the spouse and financial ability are key.
So long as a woman is fit and she can run a mile in 10 minutes, I can recruit that woman, irrespective of the age. Because also young ladies, some of them, they are 30, but they're walking like they are 60, you know, they're not fit. I wouldn't treat those one.
Safina Namkwaya became one of the world's oldest mothers after she successfully delivered through a C-section at Women's Hospital and International Fertility Center in Bokoto. The babies weighed 1.7 kilograms each. This is her second IVF treatment that comes after 3 years. IVF treatment is where there is fusion between sperm and the woman's egg in a test tube to form a fertilized egg, embryo, and the embryo is later transferred into the uterus of a woman through her cervix. Report compiled by Agnes Chotalengerire for the news.